What's up, everybody? It's Carlos from Daily Carry Solutions. We're here at Blade Show 2021 with Eric from the Outer Limitless YouTube channel and my buddy Taylor from the Case Booth. Taylor, take it away, my friend.
Hey, guys. Today, we just kind of want to show you a little bit what we got going on at Case. Right here, if you guys want to see this, we've got our two brand new knives. These are our first ever more tactical, modern EDC style knives. This one right here is called the Marilla. This is one that we actually just won the American Made Knife of the Year award for at Blade Show. It's going to be an anodized aluminum handle with a G10 inlay and an S35VN steel. Rides on a ball bearing, and it's got a nice deep carry pocket clip on it. We're really excited about this. It's the first one we're making in-house. We've done collaborations in the past, but this is still something we're doing all on our own, American Made, where we're making all of our other classic folders. So alongside this, this is the Marilla. We also have the Tonto-styled Kinzu. Same thing, anodized aluminum, a S35VN steel, so it's nice and sturdy. It's got a big, thick blade for the Tonto, meant for a lot of detail work and jabbing. It's really good self-defense or just everyday use knife for anything. This one is actually probably my personal favorite of all of them. They're each going to come in a blue, red, and black. They're going to be releasing here this August to our dealers. So really excited about these, and hopefully you guys will be able to see them here soon. Then alongside that, we also do have our more traditional folders. Like this is the this is our Volt pattern. It is the Copperhead, and then this is a Tony Bowes. We'll kind of get back to that in a minute. That's our more traditional style. The Copperhead, you know, we bring out every year. We bring out a discontinued product that we have, and we just make them for just the year, and then we put them back in the vault. So this is this year's special. Really good looking knife. You know, it's two blades. We're making it in a variety of handle materials. This right here is the red bone. So check it out. They're really cool. Like it a lot.
Now, Taylor, before you get to the next one, I do want to say, and this is what really drew me to the Case Booth. Because of the fact that we had the pandemic, one thing that I've been doing is opening up a lot of boxes from Amazon. And my girlfriend hates having to go through all my different knives, my automatics, my lockbacks, my flipper knives. And she loves something nice and simple. And one knife that she always, always turns to is my Jigged Bone Trapper from you guys. It's crazy. I keep it nice and sharp for her. She'll go through, I mean, she has destroyed Amazon boxes in the name of Case. And I just wanted to go ahead and bring that up because that's something that a lot of people, you know, ask, okay, well, is it an EDC? Yes, it is definitely an EDC. It's been an EDC longer than most of these other knives and companies have been in the market. And it's still something that we use at the house every day, literally. So
yeah, I'm glad to hear it. You know, you're right. You know, we've been around for 130 plus years. Everybody's granddad's pretty much carried one of our knives at some point. And the Trapper, like you said, it's no shocker that your girlfriend likes the knife. It's our best seller. Everybody loves them. Hunters especially like them too. We found, you know, right here, actually, that kind of gets into it. This is actually a Trapper, but this is more of a specialty Trapper.
Very nice.
Is the Tony Bowes limited edition legacy knife. Tony Bowes is one of our best knife makers. He was a good friend to Case, and he did a lot of collaborations with us, and he passed away sadly last year, and we wanted to do like legacy style knife for him. So this is an example of it. I believe we're calling it the HT Trapper, and you know, it's made of a much higher quality steel. The handle is really nice, and we're making it with everything from a mother of pearl inlay to bone to synthetic material. They're awesome. Really excited about these, and so take a look at them when you get a chance.
Now, is that available exclusively through Case, or is that something that you guys are going to have at retailers?
Yeah. So our authorized dealers will have the opportunity to purchase them and sell them at their stores. We are making a good few of them. They're going to be releasing this upcoming fall, I believe. We're really excited about it, for sure.
That's great to hear, and it's a fitting tribute.
Yeah, thank you.
Now, this kind of threw me off because I don't really seem to see Case as the fixed blade company, but yeah. Not only that, the collaboration really surprised me too. So tell me about that one.
Yeah, for sure. Well, so you know, we actually have done fixed blades for a while, but it's primarily been hunting fixed blades and, you know, gut hook, just everything like that style. This though, we did a collaboration with Winkler. Winkler Knives, great company. They do a lot of special operations, Navy SEAL style knives. That's where it kind of got started. And so Case reached out to Winkler, I believe, and we started working on a collaboration where us and Winkler get together with a special forces operator. In this case, this is Kyle Lamb's knife. and we collaborate between the three of us to make a knife in their tribute. Now, this is our most recent product out of the collaboration, the Lamb Hunter. It's one of my favorites, honestly. It's really cool. It's got this jimping right here. It's got a good grip and everything. Fixed blade. They all do come with a sheath as well. And there's just a ton of different styles of them. So we're really, really excited about these. And I personally am a big fan of them as well. So.
Well, I mean, Eric and I are actually really big fans of Winkler knives as well. If you actually go ahead and look at this, this is actually on my keychain right now. We actually ran into them over at SHOT Show 2020, yeah, just before the pandemic hit. And it's great to see some of his knives being represented well here at the Case Booth, yeah, at Blade 2021. It looks like you got your hands full with this, and congratulations for winning. I mean, the announcement was last night for Blade Show's Knife of the Year.
Yes, sir. We got the American Made Knife of the Year, so we're very, very happy about that. I think it's the second time we've won in, I think, the past 18 years or something like that. So it was a big deal for us. We worked really hard on those new knives. I think it was about 3 years of R&D to get those things out and open up an entire new just unit in our factory and start working on them. So
not really only a fantastic design, but made here in the U.S.
Yes, so sir.
That's great to know. Taylor, you've been a huge help showing this off. Thank you so much for taking a moment to talk with us about all of these different variations of some of the awesome knives that are a part of the Case catalog.
Well, thank y'all, and I hope you guys have a great rest of your show.
Likewise. Thank you.